our life was a beautiful busy. I worked at the school with the girls, and I work full-time from home, so it was just busy. She loved singing. She's an actress. She was Mary Poppins in her school play.
Singing just comes very natural, and acting just kind of goes hand in hand with it.
Every night, she wrestled 6 days a week.
My favorite thing to do is wrestling. My life was just very crazy and fun.
Our life before Olivia's diagnosis was very, very busy. We had two sports going on at the same time.
I was always hanging out with my friends, but always doing sports. That was my life. I would do anything to be in a sport. I love to travel, and I just love being outside and active.
We had just finished a wrestling tournament for New York State, and Charli had hurt her shoulder. And right after physical therapy, she was like, Mom, I feel this really weird lump on my neck. So we called her pediatrician, and immediately they checked it out, tried an antibiotic, and then he was like, let's just get it biopsied and we'll see. Charli was diagnosed with B-cell high-risk ALL. So we chose the Melodies Center to do our treatment because both Charli and I and my husband immediately fell in love with Dr. Koblick. She was very calm and she just kept reassuring me. And that was the beginning of our journey. It happened very quickly.
Our journey started actually with seeking out some assistance through her primary care. What they concluded was that she had mono. After a few months, she just started to progressively get worse. She was running 104 temperatures. Liv received the diagnosis of B-cell ALL, high risk, and it is a cancer that can move very, very quickly, and for Liv, it did. It was a shock, a lot of questioning, and a lot of tears.
Her treatment is 8 months of intense chemotherapy, and then it's 2 years of maintenance, which is at-home chemotherapy. She had methotrexate neurotoxicity, which is a methotrexate, a chemotherapy that she had, and it kind of collected in her brain, and she lost all movement for 4 days. It was on and off, which was pretty terrifying. In October, we were inpatient for another 14 days because she had a blood infection, a gut infection, and pneumonia all at the same time. I feel like we're just turning a corner.
Yeah, we're getting back on track.
Liv started her treatment on June 7th. About 14 days into it, she had started complaining about some chest pain. And at that point, I brought her to the hospital. By that time, she ended up, the blood clot shifted up into her brain, and she suffered a stroke and was unable to walk for several days and unable to move her arm for almost a month. That was pretty hard. It was really hard.
Charli met Olivia at the Children's Hospital on D7.
She had her port inserted about 12 hours before Liv was set to go in, and Mary Beth said, I think I have someone that you should meet.
In came Liv, and it literally was, I think, just an instant connection.
I just walked on in, and I was like, hi, I'm Olivia, and I have the same cancer as you. And she let me look at her port without even knowing each other, and then we became, like, best friends, so.
Yeah.
It's nice because no one that I know has gone through cancer personally, so to have someone that knows exactly what I'm going through is helpful because I can text her and be like, hey, you got this chemo, are you feeling this? I like that we're both like really strong, like physically, but also mentally. That's definitely my favorite part about her, because we both kicked butt right before we got diagnosed, so it like just, we're like the same.
Kayla and I immediately connected. There was something about her that I said, yes, she's my person. Within 3 days, we exchanged numbers.
When I need her, she's there. When she needs me, I'm there. You know, it's wonderful.
Just having someone who is going through it at the same time to talk with or to listen or say I'm scared has been such a remarkable thing. It's a positive with a negative.
They both have gone through so much together, not just the chemo, but the side effects. It's amazing. It's incredible. I'm so, so grateful Charli has her.
As soon as that elevator door opens, every person that we encounter each day on that floor makes it about you.
The Melodies Center does so much to make sure that the kids feel like this is just, you know, a chapter in their story, and they are going to do everything they can to make sure it goes as smooth as possible and they get through it with a smile on their face.
The center provides a lot, but it's the people who are there and the people that they have hired and work so hard every day, they make the difference.
When I found out, I felt fine because Dr. Kolblik, he said it was curable.
Dr. Holligan, Dr. Weintraub, Dr. Kolblik, they are like my rock there. They have given me the most hope and the most trust, and then the nurses. I just trust them so much, and I would not be where I am and have this mindset without them.
Mary Beth is the child life specialist at the Melodies Center. You walk in and she is the person that wants to make sure that you are comfortable, you are feeling loved, you're feeling supported, you're feeling like you're gonna get through the day. Thank you from the bottom of my heart. I never not have a smile on my face when I'm there.
I would have to say thank you for saving my life and that I love them so much. If you have a cancer diagnosis, that is the place to be. They are amazing.
I tell them every time that I see them how grateful and thankful that we are as a family. Thank you from the bottom of my heart.
I just want to say, like, thank you for giving me my life again. Thank you for giving me back where I wanted to be. And I just feel like when I stop chemo, it's just going to be like a new beginning.
Because of them, I'm standing here today, and I have soon to be 4 children.
I can't thank them enough. They're amazing people.
Look at our daughter. She's still with us, and we're very fortunate.
I just want to thank Dr. Pierce and all the nurses and all the staff at the Children's Hospital and Albany Med for everything that they did for me.
Thank you. You didn't just save her life, you saved her joy.
I wouldn't be here without you guys, so thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you for this. Thank you for Jacob's life.
You have to be a really, really special person to work there. And they're all amazing.
Today, I'm doing awesome. I mean, I can play a whole soccer game now. I never thought that would happen.
Thank you for giving Kelly back to me.
No, I wouldn't be here right now if it weren't for you guys.
The Melodies Center, I cannot say enough amazing things about them. They became our second home.
I say this every time to them, and I can't say it without getting emotional, because they saved him.